So when I was growing up in Hot Springs, my next door neighbor, actually a man named Kevin Kelly, was a programmer. I'm pretty sure he had his own sort of programming business that programmed for businesses around Hot Springs. And when I was first interested in computers, I think my parents reached out to him and said, hey, Taylor wants a computer, you know, what should we get? And so he actually set us up with our first computer that was like 66 megahertz, you know, just like one of those big huge towers and stuff. And that was my first computer, and I started building websites for like my favorite video games on Nintendo 64 or Super Nintendo or whatever else. Other than that, you know, I was a pretty normal kid, like to play basketball after school every day, and did a lot of typical sports stuff like that. But I was always had a little bit of a nerdy side. So when I got that first computer and started, you know, put my first website out there on the internet for everyone to access, I think it was a website actually about the game Civilization 2. I put it out there, and that was just like really cool to me that I put like this document out there that anyone in the world can see, even though I'm just like this kid in Hot Springs, Arkansas. It was just a really unique thing and really fun thing to do. And then in high school, I started programming a little more seriously on my TI-83 graphing calculator, where I programmed in all the answers for my math test, my English test, things like that. Sorry to all my teachers out there. And then in college, I majored in information technology at Arkansas Tech University, which is here in Russellville, Arkansas. I learned some C++ there, some more traditional programming stuff. And once I graduated with my four-year degree there, I was hired by Arkansas Best Freight, which is a large trucking company that's based here in Arkansas. And that's where I really developed a lot of my programming skills, because they put me through a six-month training program that taught me how to program in all of the languages they used, all of their various like workflows and sort of best development practices, and they put all of their new hires through this program. So that's where I really learned like real-world programming. And it's also where I first kind of got exposed to open source and people that like to program in their free time, which was not something I was really exposed to before that. So that's kind of when I first started playing around with my own side projects in my free time as well.